I hope this works. I have stayed silent on this subject, but feel that I have to put it out there, and those of us with allergies and children with allergies need to join as a community. And vaccinations to people and children with allergies can be done safely, and this must be addressed. I personally am severely allergic to preservatives. I have downloaded and read the science on the different preservatives in all the vaccines, including the ones in Europe not yet approved in US or Canada. And what continues to be missing is making any specific precautions for people like me, multiple chemical hypersensitivities. So I am remaining unvaccinated in isolation. Yet I fully agree we must all get vaccinated. At 80 years old, I suffered a lifetime of medical abuse and negligence, brutal torture in a gas mask to breathe, in traffic or outside since 1986. All I want is just one last cross-country ski season before I die. I had hoped someone someday would stop ignoring the issue of those with allergies, but failed to get any support from media, health departments, or ministries, etc. Now that children must soon be vaccinated, my concern is that those with allergies are being ignored as I am. Okay, I'm 80, so if I die, I'm no great loss to community. But children are, and children with allergies should be protected. They could be vaccinated safely as I could if only the health districts made appointments for those with allergies and just took simple precautions to have allergy kits available on hand, as most allergic reactions do not give time to call an ambulance. Vaccination to the entire population on this planet is necessary, or we will never get COVID-19 under control. All I am saying is, yes, we must all get vaccinations. Yes, but stop ignoring those of us with allergies and make the effort to be prepared to vaccinate us safely. For over a year, I tried several times calling our local district health department, asking for an appointment if they would take precautions to be prepared in case I take an allergic attack, and they refused, saying they don't do that. We are less likely to react to the vaccination itself, but far more likely to react to the preservatives. In my opinion, the preservatives that have been used for decades are more likely to be safer than any new modern chemical that has not been in human use. For instance, salt does not make me sick, but calcium chloride triggered a terrible attack. Olive oil does not make me sick, but canola oil caused permanent brain damage, and it took me over 40 years to recover from it. And that's a whole nother story. Oh well, I'm used to no one caring and being ignored. I just hope for the children's sake, someone someday does care. People and children like me are being born in vast increasing numbers all over the world. We are a byproduct of toxic chemicals, air, food, water, beverages, and causing chronic illness far more expensive than preventing it. I avoided publishing this for years. I have had visions on this for years. Yes, long before the pandemic. And I began to research the viruses in 1990. And I don't want to stop people from being vaccinated. I just want people like me and children with allergies to be vaccinated safely. I keep seeing visions of not their deaths, but the horrific chronic illnesses they are suffering and, like I was, continue to be ignored. I am Trudy Trahan-upchan, the founder of Free Nonprofit Research. And it's on a free website that will live long after I am dead. God bless the children.